Hi, this is Gary with MACMOST.com. Today, let's look at how you can use drag and drop on your iPad. MACMOST is brought to you thanks to a great group of more than 900 supporters. Go to MACMOST.com/Patreon. There, you can read more about the Patreon campaign, join us, and get exclusive content and course discounts. So recently, I did a video on how to use slide over and split view on your iPad so you can view multiple apps at the same time on the same screen. One of the main reasons to do that is so you can use drag and drop to move objects between apps. Drag and drop is one of the most fundamental skills for using a Mac. But thanks to split view and slide over, since we can see two apps on the screen at the same time, we can also use drag and drop there and you can accomplish a lot. So let's start off with something really basic. I'm going to go into the Files app. So I have it here. Moving your files around is one of the primary ways that you use drag and drop. And you could do that here in Files. But of course it helps if you could see more than one location at a time. So you can use split view for that. So if I go to the bottom of the screen here and bring up the dock, I could bring up the Files app again and simply move it to one side of the screen. So now I have the Files app twice. It's going to ask me to choose recent locations. And I'm going to end up here in a different folder. So actually here on the left, I have the main level of on my iPad, so locally stored files. On the right here, I'm in iCloud Drive deep down in a folder called temp, and I have a bunch of files there. Now I could drag and drop files between these locations just like I can on a Mac. So if I want to move this file onto iCloud Drive into this folder, I could simply tap it, drag, and drop it here. And it will make a copy of it. Likewise, I can move one of these files over to this folder the same way. So that's already really useful and a lot more like a Mac experience for organizing your files. But I could also do this using slide over. I'm going to get rid of the split view here and instead bring up the same location but as slide over. So I'm going to go down to the bottom here, grab files, and drag it up. Instead of going all the way to the right, I'm just going to leave it here where it's going to be a slide over window instead. And then I can select the recent location there. And now I can see the same thing. And I could drag and drop the same way between these two. But now I have the added benefit that I could actually move this window around from left to right. I can toss it off to the side to dismiss it and bring it back when I need. Now I can do more than just go from one location in Files to another location. I can go into other apps as well. So for instance, let's bring up Safari here and put that here in split view. And I was already at a page where it was asking me to drop an image for an upload. Now on a Mac, you would quite naturally drag and drop to that location. But here on the iPad, you might be used to just clicking there and then selecting a file. But thanks to split view here and drag and drop, I can do the drag and drop from the Files window into Safari over here and do the upload just like I would on a Mac. Now we can do the same thing with mail. So normally you would drag and drop to attach something to an email on a Mac. You can do it here on the iPad as well. I'll bring up mail. I'll have it be in split view here. I'll go to compose a new message. And I could drag and drop a file directly into that message just like I could on the Mac. So here's another example. We can go into the Photos app. And let's say we want to export one of these images to a file. So on the Mac, you can drag and drop out of Photos. And guess what? You can do the same thing on the iPad now. So I'm going to bring up the Files app here in split view. I'm going to go to this folder here. And I can select one of these photos and drag and drop it here. And it will export it from Photos into a file. And as you can imagine, I could do the same thing in the opposite direction. So I can drag and drop this into Photos. Now you think you would work also going directly from Photos to, say, a mail composition window. But it doesn't quite work. Replace Files over here with mail. We're already composing a message. And then we'll go here, drag and drop this in. And it seems to work. Gives you a little plus. Drop it in. And it doesn't quite happen. So it's not perfect. Maybe you'll have better luck with that. On the other hand, if we try it with the Messages app and we drag and drop it in as part of a new message, you can see it does actually go in there. You can also take a file or photo and drag and drop it into Pages. I've got a blank document and I can drag and drop this image directly into Pages. And you'll find it works in lots of other situations as well. For instance, I've got Safari here on the right, Files here on the left, and I can drag this image over here to download it and place it as a file in iCloud Drive in this case or on my Mac. I could also select text and I could drag and drop the text as well over. What I'm going to get is kind of this rich text clipping here. I can open it up and see what's inside. So lots of versatility and it's very Mac-like. So once you've mastered split view and slide over, the next thing to do is to start to use them to drag and drop just like you would on a Mac. And you find out you can do so many different things in a very desktop-like manner, but on your iPad. If you like this video, click the thumbs up button below to let me know. I publish new tutorials each weekday. Hit the subscribe button so you don't miss out.